So our today's topic is Lakinis index of coarse aggregate. Okay. So let's see the first definition of Lakinis index. What is meant by the Lakinis index? So the Lakinis index is the percentage by weight of particle whose least dimension. That means least dimension means the thickness. Okay. Thickness is less than 3/5 of their mean dimension. Okay. That means 0.6 d mean. Okay. Mean dimension is d mean. Okay, that means the weight, the percentage by weight of particles whose least dimension, that is thickness, is less than 0.6 of their mean dimension is known as Lakinis index. Then let's see the required apparatus. So here we require thickness gauge, and we can also call this Lakinis index. Okay, then we also require weighing balance machine. Then trowel and sieve sizes. Okay, different sieve sizes. So we can see here in this figure. This is our thickness gauge. Over this plate, different sizes slot is there, and all dimension is in mm. That is millimeter. Okay. So you can see here first slot is 63 to 50, then 50 to 40, then 40 to 31.5 mm. 25 to 20, then next is 20 to 16 mm, then 16 mm to 12.5 mm, after that 12.5 to 10 mm, then here 10 to 6.3 mm, and here 31.5 to 25 mm. Okay. So here different sizes is there. Then next, let's see the procedure how to find out the Lakinis index. Suppose take the sample of aggregate to be tested is sieve through a set of sieves and separate into the specified range of size, and take W1, that is the sample is W1. So for the next minimum 200 pieces of any fraction are taken and weighted properly. Okay, after that separate the flaky material, the aggregate which pass through the appropriate elongated slot of the thickness of the gauge are formed, and the width of appropriate slot would be 0.6 times the average of the range of the size, that is 3/5. Okay, 0.6 times the average of the range of size. After that, the flaky material passing the appropriate slot from the each size range of test aggregate are added and then weighted. So here, that means suppose the aggregate should be passed through the corresponding slot for the thickness gauge. That means the aggregate passing through 20 mm size and written on 16 mm size. Okay, passing through 20 mm size and written 16 mm size. So the size should be passed through only 20 plus 60. 20 plus 16 divided by 2 into 3/5, that means 0.6. okay, so it means 54 divided by 5 is equal to 10.8. That means the size shoe should be passed only through 10.8. That means the through 10 to 12.5 mm slot, and if it is passed through, then it is called as flatty aggregate. Okay. After that, then the flatty material passing the appropriate slot from each side, range of raised aggregate are added and then weighted, that is W2. Okay, then this weight is then divided by the total weight of sample taken from different range of sizes, and the ratio is expressed in the percentage, which is desired flattiness index. Okay, then next calculations is how to find out flattiness index. So there is a formula, W2 divided by W1 multiplied by 100. So what is W1 and W2? So W2 is nothing but the weight passed from 0.6 D mean size. Okay, that means 3/5 mean dimension. Okay, and W1 is equal to total weight of aggregate. Okay, and from this formula we get flattiness index. And for this test, this test is applicable to aggregate only for the aggregate size is larger than 6.3 mm size. Okay.